Hey everyone, I'm doing Adventure 9, Sneaky Endeavor. Ashardalon has stolen many important and powerful relics over the years. Can you sneak into the dragon's lair and recover a lost item of untold power? The goal is to sneak through the dungeon, retrieve a stolen treasure from Ashardalon's lair, and then find a way out of the dungeon. So I have Quinn and Heskin, the cleric and the wizard. Quinn has the Potion of Recovery, which gets rid of conditions, and Heskin has the Pearl of Power, which lets me flip up one of my used powers or items. I've done the setup, and I think everything I just read when I get to the, when I reveal what is the Horrid Chamber. So I guess I will just start it up. I'm drinking more pumpkin beer, because I recorded this the same day as the last one, so just on a roll with that. So, alright, I will begin. So, I will start by moving Quinn 1, 2, 3, and he's going to explore. The monster he gets is an orc archer, and the encounter is Sulphurous Cloud. Attack each hero on the active hero's tile. So, it's attacking Quinn, and it got a 20, so that is enough to do one and poisoned. So one damage to Quinn, and he is now poisoned. His ability is when you or any hero regains a hit point, they also remove conditions, so I gotta remember that. And then now the orc archer is going to attack, and he's going to shoot at Quinn. And he got a 9, plus a 6 is a 15. Quinn's armor is 16, so he is protected. So it will be Heskin's turn now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's going to move here, and he's going to do Arc Lightning, which lets me attack a monster, up to two monsters, but one of them can be on my... So up to two monsters within one tile. So I'll hit the archer for one. And wow... I just got a 20, and I can't level up, so it kills the archer, because the archer only has one life. The treasure I get is a throwing shield, and that will be it for Heskin, so let's draw the tile. The monster coming out is Kobold Dragon Shield. So, grab this little guy, who's going to be an annoyance. So what's going to happen is he will get the bottom tile from the stack and attach it to one of these and bring out a monster, a human cultist. Then the cultist activates and we'll go over there. So it is now Quinn's turn. At the beginning of Quinn's turn, he takes the damage from the poison. I think I'm going to use Sacred Flame. Attack one monster within one tile of you. If you hit, choose yourself or one hero on your tile. That hero regains one hit point. So I'm going to... I have to be within one. So he can move 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't want to go there. I will go 1, 2, 3. And then I will use Sacred Flame on the... Kobold is kind of high in defense. I think I'll go against the cultist. I got a 6, and his attack was a 6 modifier, so it misses. So that stinks. I can't do anything else, so I will roll for the poison. And he stays poisoned, so exploring. Monster is a snake. And the encounter, Wrath of the Enemy. I'm cursed, and this is the one where at the end of my exploration phase, find the monster closest and place it adjacent to my hero. Ugh. Alright, so monsters activate, the snake is going to move in and attack him. 15, that's going to be enough to poison him, but he's already poisoned, so whatever. He actually has that Potion of Recovery. I might use that next turn. We'll see. So it is now Heskin's turn. And he can do hypnotism or arc lightning. I think I'm going to do arc lightning. And I'm going to attack the cultist and the dragon shield. So let's attack the dragon shield first. I got a 9 and a 7 is a 16, which is enough to kill it. So goodbye dragon shield. I get a treasure. Gauntlets of ogre power. You deal plus 1 damage when you hit an adjacent monster with an attack while this item is in play. Ooh. And then I am going to do the second arc lightning on the cultist. That's going to hit and kill. So I don't get a treasure from that, but he's out. And I also get throwing shield, which attack one monster within 2 tiles of you. This action does not count as an attack action. So he's going to attack the snake as well. Clean house, hopefully. 15 and 6, that is enough to kill it. So snake's gone as well. So all the monsters have been defeated for now. And he will go 1, 2, and end it there. So the new monster is a cave bear. Ooh, big monster. And then encounter card. Lost. Take the bottom and put it on the top. So put the bottom tile onto the top. Alright. Bear's going to move in and attack Heskin. 18, ouch. I do not have anything to stop that. So I guess I'm taking 2 and I'm dazed. Alright, I think I'm going to use the Potion of Recovery before it gets to Quinn's turn so he can get rid of the poison so he doesn't have to keep losing life. I think I want to do that healing one. That would help a lot. Yeah, I will Sacred Flame. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, and then Sacred Flame. I think I want to heal myself, right? Yeah. Although, if I heal Heskin, that would mean I don't explore. So yeah, I'm just going to heal myself if I hit. I got a 9, and a 6 is a 15. The bear is a 14, so I deal 1 damage. Oh, that kind of stinks, because I could have got rid of the poison, but I guess, whatever. So I did the damage. I don't get to heal a condition off of Quinn, because he doesn't have one. And then I will do the explore. So, explore. Monster is a Grell. Out. And there's an encounter card. Oh, before encounter card, I have to do the Wrath of the Enemy, because this is at the end of my exploration phase. So I will take the... do I want to put Grill? I don't want to move the Grill adjacent. I can move the Cave Bear. Yeah, let's move the Cave Bear adjacent to me. And then now the Grell. Oh, nope, I gotta roll for Wrath of the Enemy. And it stays on me. And I will now have the Grell move in and attack. So he'll go here. And he'll attack Quinn with tentacles. 6 and 7 is 13, it's a miss. So it is now Heskin's turn. He's dazed, so this is not good. Should I attack both of them, or should I move? Well, actually, I can do a throwing shield, because it doesn't count as an attack action, and then I can move. So I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to throwing shield the cave bear. 8 and 6 is 14. That's enough to kill the cave bear. Get a treasure. Potion of Speed. Alright. And then I can move 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. All right. So I will reveal. Right. Oh, dazed is gone. Reveal this. Monster snake comes out. And no encounter, so the snake's going to move and attack. 12 and 7, 19, that's going to poison me. And it is now Quinn's turn. So Quinn, I think I want a Sacred Flame. So I'm going to attack the let's attack the grill. And it's a fail. So that did nothing. So now I need to move. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll go over here. Explore. Monster comes out. Orc Smasher. At the end of the exploration phase, I have to do Wrath of the Enemy, so I'll move the snake adjacent to me. And then roll to see if I get rid of Wrath. I do. Now the encounter card happens. Deep Tremor, attack each hero. So let's attack Quinn first. It's a miss because it's a modifier of 8. It was a 2. And a 6 and an 8 is a 14, which is not enough. Oh, 14 against Heskin. Ooh, that's going to hit him. So he takes 1 damage. Ooh. And then now it's going to be the grill moving in and attacking Heskin. Ooh, 11 and 7 is 18. That's going to hit him for 1 and daze him. Uh-oh, Heskin's not doing too hot. And then the Orc Smasher will come in and attack Quinn. 3 and 9 is 12, it's a miss. So it is now Heskin's turn. At the beginning of his turn, he takes 1 damage because of the poison. So, ouch. How can I do this? I could Shock Sphere. Choose a tile within 2 tiles. Shock Sphere could take out a couple monsters. I think I might do that. I am going to use Shock Sphere. Choose a tile within 2 tiles of you. Well, no, because he can just attack twice, right? But the Orc Smasher has 2 life, so this is not good. I'm going to do the Shock Sphere on this tile and attack both of them. So the snake's going to die, and then I'll roll for the Orc Smasher. I got a 3 and a 9 is a 12. Oh, actually, hold on. When I took a damage, because Heskin is not at a 14, he's at 16. So what did I take a damage from? Was it the grill? I think so. So I shouldn't be dazed. And I shouldn't have lost one. Because I was at a 16 and the grill did a 14, I believe. That's what happened. I'm going to say that's what happened. If it's wrong, then I screwed up. But I looked at the throwing shield and saw my modifier. So do I want to do Shock Sphere? That's the question. Yeah, I'll do Shock Sphere to attack both of them. So the snake's dead. And then what did I just roll? I think it missed. I don't remember. Okay, so I'll just say I missed. So the orc takes a damage and the snake is dead. I can't believe I forgot so quick. I get a treasure, shield of protection. I will give this to Quinn, since he needs something. And then I get the, throwing shield. I can make the free attack on the grill. I got a 9, and that's a plus 6, so 15. The grill is a 15, and I believe I have the Gauntlets of Overpower, which says you deal +1 damage when you hit an adjacent monster with an attack while this item's in play. So I kill the grill, because it has 2 life. So, I did my attacks, so I think I am going to move. He here and explore. So the monster. Oh boy. Oh, I forgot to do my invisibility. That's what I was going to do because I'm so low on life. Invisibility will make him invisible. And what I drew was a Legion Devil, which is awful if I didn't use invisibility. But trust me, I had it in my mind I was going to do it because I'm low on health right now. I'm going to roll for the poison. It stays on me. And then encounter card. Poison Dart Trap. I am going to pay the experience to get rid of that. Because I don't want traps right now. And then the Legion Devils will activate, and since he's invisible, they'll just move. Like so. And it will be Quinn's turn. Ah, these Legion Devils are annoying. I guess I will do a Blade Barrier. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 will get me there. Yeah, what I'll do is I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I'll do a Blade Barrier, which lets me put 5 blade tokens on 5 different squares on this tile. So I put the 5 blades down, and then that's pretty much all I can do with him, because that was my attack, I guess. That makes sense that he would use up his attack for that. And then exploring time. Monster is a Grell. So let's place the Grell here. Then we will get the encounter card. It's the Pit. Oh no, and I don't have enough to negate it. Ah. Oh boy. Alright, place the Pit token. Alright, place the Pit token on the active hero's tile. And another thing that I mentioned it in that other video when it ended, but yeah, these are on, they're not physically blocking the heroes, it just means that they're there. So, place it on the active hero's tile, attack each hero on the active hero's tile, so I will roll. Ooh, that is going to be enough to do 2 damage to Quinn and place him on the Pit. So Quinn is on the Pit right now. And then, I probably should have healed when I was walking by. I guess now the Grell will move in. Well, Orc Smasher moves in and attack. Well, he's still invisible, so this just moves in, and then the Grell will move and take a damage from the bleed. And then now it will be Heskin's turn. He takes a damage from the poison. He's no longer invisible. I guess I could Arc Lightning and take out the non-Legion Devil dudes. I think that's what I'm going to do. So I will Arc Lightning. First one against the Grell. 7, and 7 is 14. The Grell is 15, but since I'm adjacent, oh no, I don't get any, wait, plus 2 armor, ah, so it misses. Alright, and then the next attack is on the ogre. I got an 8, plus a 7 is a 15, which is enough to hit, to kill him, so he's gone. And I get a treasure. Magic sword, plus 1 to attack rolls. I guess I'll give it to Quinn. And then I get the free attack, which I'll use on the Grell. 14 and 6 is enough to kill it. So the Grell's gone. And then I will move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into the corner. And let's see, I need to move these, and I will explore. All right. Right, the monster is going to be Gibbering Mouther. And let's see. Oh, I got a roll for poison. Poison's gone. And then now the encounter card. Lurker's Strike. Draw a monster card and place its figure on the active hero's tile. Attack the active hero. So this is the attack on Heskin. 6 and 4. Or 6 and 8 is 14. I have 16 defense, so that misses. But I gotta draw a monster. Ooh, it's the cave bear. Place it on the tile. I have to place it adjacent. Nope, just on the tile. Maybe I want to place him adjacent, because that strike is nasty. Alright, so monsters activate. The Legion Devils will all move on to these, I guess. Well, let's see. I don't know, because you're supposed to move them on to the marking. So if I go one at a time, I'll move it onto that one, and he dies. And then the next one will move to it, and then the next I can choose, so I'll move him here and he dies. So I got rid of 2. The Gibbering Mouther will attack and miss, and then the Cave Bear will attack. And that's going to hit and kill me, I think. Because that's 6 and that's 21, so yeah, Heskin dies. Alright, so it's Quinn's turn now, and for Quinn, he has to do this. If a hero is on this card at the start of his or her hero phase, roll a die. It's a 2, so he's stuck. Okay, so I'm going to have to use his ability after this goes off. So he's stuck, so he skips the hero phase. It's now exploration, nothing happens. At the beginning of the villain phase, I'm going to use his Astral Refuge. And that lets him pull, it says choose a tile within 2 heroes of you, so I guess himself is fine. Remove the hero from the tile. Am I even technically on a tile? That might not count. That's a good question. He might be stuck on there because he's technically not on a tile. So I guess I won't be able to use that. If I'm wrong, then I'm just hurting myself more. So, encounter card. Draw a monster card and place its figure on any tile with an unexplored edge. So he draws an Orc Smasher, and I'm going to put him way over here. So he's going to activate and move one tile. So it is now Heskin's turn, so he will come back to life and get 3 HP, which is not a lot. He can attack up to 2 monsters. Yikes. He can move a total of 12 if need be. So what would that be? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I'm going to do that afterwards. So first I'm going to Arc Lightning, and attack a Legion Devil first. And that's going to kill the Legion Devil and get a treasure. Flying Carpet, that's kind of useless. So Legion Devil's gone. Then I will attack the Bear. Miss. And then I will use the Throwing Shield on the Bear. And that'll do a damage to the Bear. And then now I will move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then I'll use my Potion of Speed, which lets me move up to my speed again. So 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. After that, I explore. So, monster comes out. Oh, are you kidding me? It's another Legion Devil set. Might not live. Alright, so Gibbering Mouther will move. The Bear will move. And then the Legion Devils will surround and attack Tesco. So let's see if he lives. 2 and 11 is a miss. 5 and 11 is 16, which unfortunately is a hit. And then 12 is definitely a hit. So he is down to 1 life. Oh boy. Alright, back to Quinn. So Quinn at the start will roll. And he is out of the pit. So let's. Where do I put him? On the pits tile. So where do I want to put him? I guess I'll put him right here. And then he will. He'll use his Sacred Flame on the bear. So 7 and 6 is 13, plus 1 for the magic sword is enough to kill the bear. So the bear's dead. Draw a treasure. Wand of Polymorph. And then, let's see, he killed the bear, so he actually gets to heal 1 because he used Sacred Flame. Then he can move 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, just out of luck. So I guess I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'll explore there. And the monster that comes out is going to be a Dwerdwer guard. Put him here. Monsters activate, so Orc Smasher way up here moves 1, and then the guard is going to bring 1 out from the bottom. And the monster for that is a snake, and then the snake will activate and move 1 here. So it is now Heskin's turn. He's got 1 life, and he needs to kill a lot of stuff. This is not good. I guess he's going to use Hurled Breath. Choose a tile within 2, attack each monster. This does not count as an attack. So, I'll attack 1 Legion Devil. 7 and 5 is 12. Legion Devils are 16, so that's a miss. What is this modifier? 5, so I need to be hitting 11s. 8 is a miss. 12 is a hit, so 1 of them dies. And this did not count as an attack. So the treasure, Boots of Striding, gets plus 1 to speed. I guess I'll give it to Quinn, because he's slower. And then I can actually do my attack, so I'll do Arc Lightning to attack both of those. 17's a hit. And 19 is a hit. Or 19 plus 7 is 26. So both of them will die. Legion Devils are gone. Do I want to move? I guess I'll just go 1, 2, 3. Not that it matters. And then explore. And of course, Horde Chamber entrance. So some things are going to happen, and they're not good in respect to where I'm at. So first I make the chamber. Got a large chamber, so. The entire thing is going to be here. So that is the first piece of the puzzle. Like that, so you can see everything. Alright, so what do I do after that? Lots of reading. Horde Chamber entrance. Draw and place the tiles, which I did. This is Ashardalon's treasure chamber. Place the Rage Drake figure on any chamber tile. So the Rage Drake I will put over here, and his card should come over to me. Each player draws a monster and places the corresponding figure on a chamber tile. So, Heskin is getting a Dwerdwer guard. I'll place him here. Here, I guess. And then Quinn is getting a grill. So the grill will be placed here. And I need to mark those two because once I need to kill them. Remove the following treasure tokens. 100, 200, 300, 400, and a treasure. Select one of these tokens for each chamber tile in play. So there's six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to have to shuffle them and I think put them face down. Shuffle and place them face down randomly. So let's do this really quick. Next, Ashardalon. When a hero reveals the horde chamber, place the Ashardalon figure on the start. So Ashardalon is at the start tile. Draw the top three encounter cards and shuffle Ashardalon Breathes in. So 1, 2, 3. Here's Ashardalon Breathes. So I'll shuffle that in. And place these four on top of the encounter deck now. Treasure tokens. They are face down. They represent valuable treasure. A hero that ends his or her hero phase next to a token can pick it up, provided there are no monsters on the tile. Turn the token face up and place it on the hero's card. The token is a treasure. Draw a treasure card. Tunnel exit. When the hero reveals the tunnel exit tile, he or she has found another way to escape from the dungeon. Victory is when the hero finding the treasure token and escaping the dungeon with the item. To escape, I have to end my hero phase on the stairs, on the start tile, or on the stairs on the tunnel exit tile. As long as one hero carries the item out of the dungeon, the hero wins. So when I reveal it, I'm supposed to read, "The chamber ahead appears to be one of Ashardalon's treasure vaults. The rage drake within turn towards you and attacks just as you hear a great roar in the distance." Let's see, that was Heskin revealing that, so he's revealed that. First, Ashardalon activates, which is he moves one tile towards the closest to the hero with the highest HP, so he'll move one. Then the Rage Drake will move. Jason, within one, it just moves one tile, so he'll move here. After that, it's the Gibbering Mouther. He's going to attack Quinn. And miss. And then it's the Dwer Guard, who will just move one to the closest hero. He's here. And now it is Quinn's turn. Alright, so Quinn, what is he going to do? He needs to come. Ooh, this is really bad. He's got to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, no, why am I doing this? Astral Refuge, I can use at the start of any villain phase. Choose one hero within two tiles of you, remove that hero from the tile at the start of that player's next hero phase, the player places the hero on any tile. I was dumb and I should have used that on Heskin's hero phase, but I'm not gonna go back. That was my stupidity. So I am going to Sacred Flame and attack. What are there? Two guards out, right? I guess I will attack the snake with a sacred flame. 4 and 6 is a 10. The snake is a 13, so that's a miss. So I've got 5 to move. I guess I will go 1, 2, 3, 4 and in there. So I did not explore, so an encounter card happens. Occupied lair, draw the tile from the bottom of the tile stack, place the tile next to the closest... draw a tile from the bottom of the tile stack, place the tile next to the closest unexplored edge, draw a monster and place its figure on the tile, place one treasure token on that tile. Treasure tokens don't help me much right now, because all I care about are the ones over there. So this one came from the bottom, and the monster is... You gotta be kidding me. It's Legion Devils. So, guess what? These guys pop in here. And since, what was that? At the beginning of the villain thing, that's when I'm using my Astral Refuge. So, Quinn is now off the board. And he will come back at another time. So, villains activate. Orc Smasher moves one. Nope, before Orc Smasher, it's... Ashardalon moves one. Orc Smasher hiding behind him moves one. Oh, no, before Orc Smasher just wants to move. Rage Drake has to go, so he's going to move here. And now Orc Smasher can move. Then the Dwer guards activate, so this one moves. And this one will just move adjacent to the hero because he's within one. I know, he just moved one tile towards the closest hero. I'll put him there. The snake moves. The Grell is going to move and take a damage. And finally, the Legion Devils will all move. So many monsters. I don't know if I can do this or not. We'll see. Heskin's turn. He actually can do a decent amount of stuff. I need to kill both of those, so let's... You deal plus one damage when you hit an adjacent monster with an attack with this item. Okay, so I'm going to use my... Yeah, I'll do that. I will arc lightning this guy and the Drake. So, first one... The guard. Kill the grill in the meantime. So that's enough to kill. It'll do one damage, but then the gauntlets, since I'm adjacent, will actually kill him. So the guard is one of the guard or one of the guys in that room that I need to kill are dead. Second one, I'm attacking the Drake. 11 and 7 is 18. The Drake has a 13 light or 13 armor, so he takes one. And let's see, I will move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then I can use my free attack with the throwing shield on the grill. 12 and 6 is 18, which is enough to hit the grill, and the good thing about that is the... Gauntlet, since I'm adjacent, will also do another damage to that grill. So, the grill's dead, it had two. Actually, I should keep these with all my things. So, grill's gone. Did I get a treasure? I don't think I did. Yeah. Elven Cloak. The player to your left places that monster... Oh, use before drawing a monster card during your exploration phase. The player to your left places that monster instead. So, I could prevent... Well, I'm not... Actually, yeah, I'll keep these up there. So, I don't know why I moved the Gibbering Mouth there last time. I don't think he should have moved, because all of those guys moved. Yeah, Gibbering Mouth there is under the control of Heskin. That was my mistake. But it doesn't matter, because I'm going to move him there anyway. So, whatever. So, I'm killed that. So, at the end of my hero phase, I can flip this. And it's gold, which is not good for me. I didn't explore, so an encounter card. Bloodlust, at the start of your hero phase, take a damage. I'm negating that with all this experience that I have. So negate that. Then a Ashardalon activates, so he'll move in. Then the Drake will move there. And then the Gibbering Mouther will do what I meant for him to do. taken damage from the blade barrier. And then that's it for... Oh, flip up one of your used powers or items. Maybe I should go with this. No, I don't need to. Alright. So, that's it for me. I am going to begin Quinn's turn, and at the start of his turn, he teleports back in. I can place it on, place the hero on any tile. So, what do I want to do? I am going to place him here. And then when I do that, I'm using Healing Him. You and one other hero on your tile regain 2 hit points. So, I will be healing Heskin and myself. If you hit choose yourself or one hero on your tile, that regains 1. Alright, I'm going to Sacred Flame the Drake. I got a 19, so that's going to hit him for 1. And I'm going to heal Heskin 1. What else do I have? 1 extra speed, flying carpet, shield. I'm going to have to move him 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll move him here and then end it so I flip this. It's 100 gold, so that's not good. And counter card, lava flow, I'm negating that. Now it's going to be Ashardalon activates. Now at the entrance, this isn't good, because if that's where it is, I am in a lot of trouble. So, Ashardalon moved, Rage Drake is going to move in and attack with a charge. It was a 1, so it failed. Then the Orc Smasher moves 1. Dwer Guard moves 1. Snake will move 1 and die, just to get the snake off the board. Legion Devils are next. They all move. And now it is Heskin's turn. I think I know what I have to do. I'm going to use Pearl of Power to flip over my invisibility power, right? Yep, I can flip over invisibility. So what I am going to do is, I could be really mean and mess with Ashardalon. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to go, well, first I get my throwing shield I can do for free. 8 and 6 is 14. The Drake is a 13, so it does 1 damage plus another because of my orc gauntlets. Then I am going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to use Hypnotism. Choose a monster within 1 tile of you. Move that monster 1 tile. If it ends adjacent to another monster, make an attack against the second monster. So I'm going to hypnotize Ashardalon and make him come over here and attack this orc. So 4 and 9. Is 13. The orc is a 15, so it misses. And then at the end of my... I'm going to do invisibility. Just to be safe, right? Yeah. And then at the end, I get to reveal this. And it is the treasure. So I get to draw a treasure. It's the Wand of Fear. I think I will give it to Heskin. Yeah. And then that is, now I have to do all the bad guy stuff after my encounter, because I didn't do that. Ashardalon Breathes. This card cannot be canceled. If Ashardalon is not in play, discard it. Attack each hero within 1 tile of Ashardalon. There are none. After the attack, shuffle this card face down with the top 3 encounters. So 1, 2, 3. So that was a good move. Sometimes I'm smart. I don't think I'm smart around the other people I play with, but so that was the encounter. Ashardalon activates now, so he's gonna move 1. He's like, why did you do that? I was right here. I got deja vu. The Rage Drake is now going to move one. Actually, I'll move him here. Whoa, don't do a flip, man. He moves one. This is Heskin we're talking about, so the Gibbering Mouther will move one. Alright, so that's all the bad guys. It's now Quinn's turn. So Quinn is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. Could he have attacked? Choose one adjacent monster, attack him once. Nope, he couldn't have. So I'm just going to go over here. In my hero phase, I got some gold and reveal the next card, which during setup I knew was the tunnel, because what you do is you take three, shuffle in the chamber entrance, and place it under the eighth, and then under those four you place this, so this had to come after all the ones that I drew. Well, it might not have. I think it's actually the worst luck that I drew the Horde Chamber and then the tunnel, because that means this was farther down than I wanted it. But anyway, he explores, monster comes out, it's a cultist. Alright, so encounter card, because there was a black triangle. It's a Ashardalon Breathes. Holy crap. Actually, invisibility doesn't protect me from this, because it says monster attacks that attack every hero on a tile still hit me. So Ashardalon is breathing, and Heskin's kind of fortunately there. 11 and 9 is 20, so it'll do 3 damage. Whew. And then now I shuffle this back into the top. Ah, that was bad shuffling, which people are used to seeing me do. Alright, Ashardalon activates. He's going to move in, but he doesn't see me because I'm invisible. The Rage Drake will move one closer to him, so I'll just move him here and show that Heskin is in a world of hurt if he doesn't leave. So, Rage Drake, and then now it's going to be... Oh, do I have to kill the monsters? I did not look at that. Okay, so I completely forgot something, as well as... So, the first thing is I can just leave. I don't have to kill these guys. The thing I forgot was that I could not pick up a treasure if it was adjacent, or if there was a monster on that tile. And I think the only time that happened was when that Grell was here. And if that was the case, then what I picked up at that point was 300 gold, so it wouldn't have mattered too much. I mean, it might have stalled me a turn or so. I don't know how much of a difference that would have made. Or I could have just gone for one of those. But that's an unknown, which I don't... No way to rewind to do that. And I think I'm actually going to finish this so I can... I don't think I'm going to play this again just for that one little slip-up. Hope you all understand that. Anyway, the Drake activated. Now the Orc Smasher is going to move in. The Guard is going to move in. Legion Devils move in. Human Cultist is going to attack. 6 and 6 is a 12, and that's a miss. And now it is Heskin's turn, and this is going to be the game ender because he can move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 onto the tunnel exit, and that is the requirement to win, is to have a hero with the treasure token to leave on the tunnel exit or start tile. So I win. I think that one small mistake wasn't too detrimental to my winning, so I'm just going to call it as I won this one and move on to the next one so you guys can see that one. So thank you for watching. Any more mistakes I made, I can't believe I actually caught that one within the video. Normally I don't catch them that quick. Other than that, please like, comment, share, whatever you feel like doing, I guess. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.